Hi there, Andy back again with another one of our easy guitar songs. This time, as you can imagine, it sounded like Imagine by John Lennon, and you were not imagining it because it is Imagine by John Lennon. And today I am going to, it's a good one, he's laughing his head off, that's quite funny. Anyway, we'll carry on. So today I'm going to show you the basic chords that go with this piano-based song. So I'm going to show you the easy version, how you can strum along to it, but also a couple of embellishments that you can add into it to give it a little bit of flavour and stuff as well. So let's just crack on. I'm just going to break it down segment by segment for you. So we're starting off with an intro, which is actually also forms the verse as well. And the chords we're going to be using are a C major, a C major 7. This is where you take your forefinger off the C note, which is the first fret on the B string, and play the open B. And you hear that sort of melody line, like that. And then you've got an F chord, F major. And that is the intro and also the verse, or the first part of the verse. And it just literally goes like this. Nice easy strum. So I'm sort of doing something like this. It's just a nice, easy up and down motion, but you're not actually going up, down, up, down, up, down like that. Just sort of feeling your way through the song. And maybe at the end of the F sequence, a little bit more sort of power on the, when you go back to the C again. So, and when we play that C major 7, I'm trying to put a heavier downstroke in. So you can hear that melody line, because it really is crucial to the song. Okay. And that is the verse and the first part of the intro, and the first part of the verse. And also, I said I'm going to show you a couple of embellishments that you can put into it if you like. And the two things here that I'd like to share with you, maybe three things I'd like to share with you, is obviously the iconic melody line, which follows the F chord, it's the F chord, and as it goes back into the C again. So it goes like this. Okay, so what I'm playing there is an A note, second fret of the G string, the B flat note, third fret of the G string, open B, and first fret of the B string, which is C note, sorry. And it's quite difficult to play that. You're playing the F, and then you have to get straight back into that C chord again. But the good thing is, because you're playing that C note there, and I try and use my forefinger, you're already in place. Now when you go back to that C note, you can, or the C chord, your little finger there, or your middle finger there, which is playing the C note, the F note, I can't talk this morning, the E note, which is the second fret on the D string, you can take that off and play a little melody line. So when you're playing that C chord, you can actually just to sort of give it a bit more of flavour and colour. And also, instead of the F chord, you can play an F major 7, which, similar to the C major 7, is the full F chord, but you're not going to play the F note, which is the first fret on the E string. You're going to take it off and play the open E. So you're playing the F with the open E. So it's good. So what you have been playing, what I have shown you, could also sound like this. Like that, you see. So, two different ways you can play it. I would suggest learning the easy bit first and then sort of working your way up those other bits, because that melody line, the, is quite challenging. So that is your intro and the first part of the verse. And the second part of the verse, when I think it first says, imagine all the people, goes like this. Those of you that have known me for a few years know I've got tiny little hands, so I've had to improvise a little bit of this, which you probably won't need to because you've probably got bigger digits than me. But anyway, the chords we're using for this, we're using an F major, which we've done already, C major, a D minor, and a G chord. Sometimes I play the G the traditional way, but sometimes I also include the D note, which is the third fret on the B string, like this. Doesn't make any difference at all. So, it starts off with an F to a C. And then to the D minor. So we'll do that first bit again. Then I'm going to hit the C note there, which is the third fret on the A string, because it's sort of got a melody line that goes like that. So it's sort of a mini underlying melody line, which is the D minor just before you hit the G. So if I show you that bit now, it goes like this. See, I've so small hands, I can't hit it. I'll do it one more time. To the G. Now, if you've got bigger hands than me, you'll be able to actually hit that C there with the tip of your pinky, with your little finger, and probably continue to play the chord. But I'm just hitting the note and then coming off again, and then going on to the G. So the full sequence sounds like this. Then back into the next verse. Okay, so that might take a bit of work. You don't have to use that C note if you don't want to. As I said, it's sort of another additional embellishment, and you could play it like this. So it's entirely up to you. Okay, so there we have an intro and a verse. Okay, very, very simple. Now my favourite bit, which has got a fantastic lick in it, fantastic little chords. It's really clever. It's like a melody line sort of based around chords, and it's like this. And that's, I'm calling that the chorus. And so you may say that I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. So what we're playing the chords here are C, F major to C. Sorry, got that wrong. F major to G. Then we play a C, C major 7, like we did at the beginning with that melody line. And the next part of the melody line is an E, E major to E7. So you can hear that melody line. And then it repeats it all again. So you've got F, G, C, C major 7, E, E7. Okay, so that's the main part of the riff, and it finally ends up on a C. So what I'll do, I'll play the riff for you again, nice and slowly, just so you can hear, so I can sort of show you what those melody lines sound like. So it's after 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the end bit. And the world would live as one. Like that. And then it just goes straight back again into another verse. Now again, the rhythm patterns for this, I'm actually not even consciously doing anything, thinking I've got to play it like that. I'm just trying to get some highs and lows, like every time I hit the F in the chorus, I try and hit it slightly harder. But it's just a nice little... So So when I'm playing that melody line there, I'm really trying to put the downstrokes in so you can really hear them. And that basically is all there is to the song. I think it goes intro, verse, verse, chorus, ending up on the C. And that's all there is to it. So have a little play around with that. Put your own embellishments in and try and do the more complicated version and the bits that I've added in for you as well. And hope you really enjoy playing that cracking song. Catch you all soon. Ciao for now.